Daniel, I want to ask you about these climactic monologues that you have in this film. There's two of them, which is
one way to describe them.
You could reenact them, please. Climactic
moments.
Yes.
I mean, for the audience, there's so much fun to listen to, but they strike me as they must be a nightmare to work out how to play, because you've got to impart all of this information in this really kind of dense but entertaining way. So tell me about how you play those scenes and how you approach those kind of big speeches where Benoit lays out how things are to the rest of the group.
Thank you for having us here today. Just what a wonderful turnout. It's lovely to see. It's the first press conference I've done for... I mean, it's crazy. It's like a different reality. But yeah. So nice to see you all.
Humans.
Humans. Oh, my God. How do I do it? I get them into my system as much as possible so that they are, the line learning is a kind of something I've done way before. I've got it there, and I try and make them as, and then forget it. And just try and loosen it up and just try and do that acting thing, which is that think of it on.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Goodness.
I knew that's
and
why.
The lights go out. Ryan.
I knew there was a room. Is everybody okay?
Is this a part of the show?
Since the third movie has begun.
That's a great.
Oh. You're in that right?
It started anyway, at a Dunkin'.
Yeah, I just do that, try and do that acting thing where you think you're being in the moment and you think it is. I mean, the great thing is I have Ryan's amazing words, so that's really a good basis for anything.
Is the rhythm of obvious in the screenplay, or do you have to kind of find that when you're playing the scene?
There's a lot of rhythm in the screenplay. There's a lot of what Ryan's thinking, and then I try and put what I'm thinking in it, and somewhere between the two, we find a balance, I think. Mm-hmm.